And here we go. Hey there, good morning to you. Welcome to Infinity Highway with Kel the Baseman, Max Spaz, and Bronger in the truck. How y'all doing? Greetings to you from somewhere up here in Minnesota, just northwest of Brainerd, where we have just picked up our backhaul load about 42,000 pounder of pet food from Barrett's pet food joint place.
3/4 mile, keep right to US 10.
Of which we are hauling out to Sparks, Nevada to a PetSmart, I think. It's PetSmart or Petco. I think it's PetSmart. Yeah, we're just making our way along the highway.
Keep
210
right to US 10
westbound. We're about to jump onto the regular old 10 here. Let's see if I can get you a locality. So we are currently about to go through the town of Motley, the Motley Crew of Minnesota here.
Continue on US 10.
Oops. Where, yes, as you can see, winter is setting itself in here, sort of. It's beginning to set itself in here. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, shit, they got scales here. Holy crap balls. You know what? We need to go one in that scale. Ha, amazing. Yes, we do. Huh. I'm surprised that scale did not come up when I did a search for it. Very interesting. Well, what a bonus. I thought we were going to have to make our way all the way out to Fargo.
Turn right on US 10.
To get this load scaled.
Turn right on US 10.
But yeah, winter is beginning to set itself in over here. All the little ponds and stuff are all frozen over. Probably got a couple, or like an inch of ice on them or something like that. Wow, those are three really nice looking Peterbilts right there. Man. Those are freaking hot rods right there. Damn.
U-turn.
Yeah. So, really quick as we get ready to hop on this here scale, we got Wednesday, December 1st, 2021. Time is 9:31 in the a.m. Max, get down. Thirty-six degrees out here in the town of Motley. About 1,200 foot elevation, and we got 1,674 miles to go out there to Sparks. And hang tight for a second.
22. Thank you.
I love it. I really do. I finally have been able to meet a few people. With outrageously awesome and adorable northern accents. I love it. I just freaking love it. I really do. Oh, yeah.
Oh, impossible.
It's cold outside.
Make a U-turn.
It's cold outside. I freaking love it. I don't know. I think it's just, it's adorable.
When possible, make a U-turn.
The lady, who loaded us up this morning back there in Brainerd, she came out to give us paperwork. She starts talking to me. She sees Max. She's like, oh, what a nice dog. I don't know. I can't do it right now. I'm still a little bit congested from this cold that I caught. But it's just freaking adorable. I really do love it. All right, I'll be back. Okay, rock and roll, here we go. So, yeah, it's a good thing we went ahead and pulled in. I mean, we're about 440 pounds overweight on our trailer tandems. Which isn't horrible. But, honestly, I'm a little bit surprised that we're that much, that heavy. We're 34,440 on our trailer tandems. And like 30,000 and something on our drives. And what I'm surprised at is that we were that far out of balance, because I thought I had it situated pretty well. And so, adjusted it like just enough to get us under on our trailer tandems. I could adjust it more. I probably should, and I very well might stop once we get into North Dakota. And put a little bit more weight on our drives, but you know, it doesn't really matter. We're legal. We're not necessarily perfectly balanced, but we don't really need to be. So. Our gross is like 75,000. Staples. So we got 102 miles left to go here on the 10. I believe it's, the 10 is going to take us all the way out to the 94, where we'll be connecting, well, out to Fargo, where we'll be connecting with the 94, I should say. Just inside the state line of North Dakota, I believe. Yeah, we'll see you somewhere up here along the way. Snowy snow, here we go. We are still here in Minnesota.
Turn right on US 10.
And as you probably just heard, we're still running along the Highway 10 westbound. We just went ahead and did a quick pit stop at the rest area here. So we got about 50 miles to go to get out there to Fargo. Becker County. You need to get down, dog. Starting to bug out because I haven't got him out since we stopped here at welcome to Fargo. Yeah, since we stopped here at Petro Fargo, North Dakota. He's bugging. But it has not been very long since we got him out, so he's fine. Good for another couple few hours. It's like, yeah, it says you. I want to get out now, Devin.
In 1/4 mile, turn right on 45th Street South, then take the ramp on the right.
Funny, they got this alien, what's it called, alien zone or something over here on the left corner. Let me see over there on that corner. Let's see, what's it called, space aliens something or another. It's like, I don't know, like a fun zone for kids or something. It's probably kind of like a Chuck E. Cheese, you know.
Anybody
out there
turn right on 45th Street South, then take the ramp on the right.
The alien version. What's funny about it is it's just not the kind of place that you would really expect to have here in Fargo, North Dakota. It's more of a Nevada thing, you would think, but whatever. Aliens sell.
On the right to I-94 West toward Bismarck.
Yeah, if we can ever make it, we will. We'll do just that. Fargo, North Dakota, where it's relatively warm compared to what we've been used to for the most part of the day. It's actually in the low 50s. Max, get down. Get down. I've got some, I just picked up a thing of chicken strips and I got them up there on the dash underneath the windshield waiting to be eaten, and he knows that they're there. But yeah, 54 degrees as I speak. Time is now 1:41 in the PM. Elevation 888 feet. He's determined to get to my chicken strips. Absolutely determined. We have not been off that many miles so far as of yet. So it's probably not really worth mentioning. We got 1,551 miles to go. 1,551. Get down, man. Seriously. He's doing everything he can think of to try and get up there and get my chicken. Get down! You little freaking jerk. Seriously, you're being a pain in the ass, dog. Police station, next right, open with flashing. Okay, that is not flashing. Cool, I guess we can pass it then. All right, gotta go. We'll talk to y'all later. All right, well, welcome back. And greetings to you now from Pilot Flying J. Good job, Max. Pilot Flying J over here in, I believe it's West Glendive, Montana. And we're going to go ahead, I think, and call it a night. Yeah, I think that's what we're going to go ahead and do here. Sleeper berth, save, yep. And pick it back up bright and early tomorrow morning. It's only 6:30 in the p.m. now. 49 degrees outside. We're at 2,100 foot elevation. And we worked our mileage down to 1,168 left to get out there to Sparks. We did, we only did 545 miles today, but that's all right. This load actually, I guess, I probably already mentioned it, doesn't deliver until Saturday, or that's our appointment, is for Saturday. So, in any event, we'll be getting out there Friday, and if we can deliver Friday, we'll do that. It's no big deal, because 1,168 miles we can knock out in about 18 hours. So, I'm going to go ahead and take some NyQuil and call it a night. So, but we'll bring you back in here tomorrow, I figure. Yep. Good night. See you tomorrow. Morning. Today is Thursday, December 2nd, 2021. The time is 7:05 in the a.m. About 35 degrees outside. It's kind of a warm 35 degrees, actually. I mean, it's just not really like a blistery cold 35. Precipitation, that is drizzle, that is not snow on the windshield. So that's a positive thing.
Turn right on I-94 West.
December 2nd, seriously, it's all freaking December 2nd. It's amazing. It happens so fast. But I guess that's the way that goes when you're out on the road for a month at a time. That just flies by. Crazy.
that we have a 42,000 pound load in the back. I feel okay about it. It's just that the gusts are in excess of 60 miles an hour right now. And they are swirling gusts. So they're kind of hitting from either side, kind of unpredictably. scenery, yeah.
I figured.
Yep.
All right, we'll see you in a minute.
Southbound on US 191, just south of what was it, Brisbane or something? I don't think it was Brisbane. Shoot, you know what? I forgot what it was called. Brent, no, hang on. South of Belgrade, there in Montana. There we go. Yes, we pulled off the I-90, took left, started making our way down the 191, and there was a way station open there, and once again, we got called in, and had to go bring in our paperwork. Are basically our shipping papers, our truck registration, trailer registration, driver's license, and logbook. And allow him to inspect it all real quick. And he sent us off with no violations. So we fooled him. I think that's the third time that I've been called in for an inspection in the last 2 months, something like that. It was back in Idaho, just east of Spokane, Washington, that we got pulled in. And they did a level 4 inspection, truck and trailer. And then a couple, 2 or 3 weeks ago, while we were out on this run, we got pulled in over in New Mexico for a level 2 inspection. And then here once again. So so far so good. No no violations as of yet. So that's always a good thing. Back there at the way station, you know, we were sitting there chit-chatting while he was doing all, you know, inspecting all the paperwork and stuff, and I was talking about how, yeah, it's pretty damn windy out there and this and that. He's like, yeah, well, if you're going, you know, he's like, are you going southbound 191? I says, yeah. He's like, well, you'll be going through the canyon right there, and it'll shield you from all the wind pretty good. I says, that's great news. So far so good. He said about for like about 80 miles. It's awesome and amazing scenery. It's routes like this, I've said it before, it's routes like this is the why I got into doing this line of work. This is why I do this job right here. what, we're going to do a two-parter here, I figure, because this should be a pretty amazing drive. We already got quite a bit of time piled up on this one, so I'm going to wrap this one up, and we'll bring it right back in, and so you can enjoy this drive down 191. So stay tuned for part two. Hope y'all are doing well. Thanks for watching Infinity Highway. We'll see you somewhere down the road. See ya.